Parked vehicles in London often create a hazard for cyclists. They create a pinch point. Where there are useful things like central reservations, they tend to be too small and don't really create a good feeling of comfort. Most roads are dedicated to motor vehicles. There is no allocated space for bicycles. Even the pavement is cluttered with signs for cars. Crossing the road as a pedestrian takes a very long time. The light remains red while motorists drive by. When people do cross, they usually cross against the red light. This is a behaviour that they've become used to because it's what you have to do to cross the road in London. In this case, we started crossing against the red light, and by the time we reached the reservation near the other side, there was a red light again. Everyone walked against the red light. I found the bike share system to work very well. A lack of bikes was never really the problem in London. The problem is that the roads are not conducive to cycling. From watching the traffic, it's quite clear that no one gets anywhere very quickly, no matter which mode of transport they've chosen. People drive a lot because it's the least awful option. Cyclists habitually squeeze through gaps between roadworks and vehicles, in between cars. This is the only way to get ahead of the traffic in London. Side streets are nearly as unforgiving as the main roads. The shared space at Exhibition Road is not really shared. Motor vehicles dominate here. Cyclists are squeezed. Pedestrians have a separate space. The middle of the road, with cars streaming by on both sides, is not a comfortable place to be. This cyclist adopted that position in order to try to get a head start on the other side of the road. This is necessary only because Exhibition Road does not provide pleasant conditions for cycling. Look what happens to the next few cyclists. Is it comfortable to be overtaken in this way? I don't think so. There's a lot of waiting in London. Cyclists cannot make fast journeys, and the average cycling speeds are therefore very low. By comparison, in the Netherlands we have an efficient network of cycle routes, which makes our journeys a lot faster. The lack of space for cycling in London leads to people doing some very strange things sometimes. Watch the cyclist on the left in the picture. This is not in the highway code. It's not the way you're supposed to behave according to the law. By doing this, he claims some space for himself and can proceed more safely than if he had obeyed the law. These sorts of manoeuvres are quite common in London.